Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Stoney. Thank you for watching this video. I haven't posted a video in quite a while, and I'm starting a little bit late on this one. So as you can see by the title, this is my wife and I and my son and my daughter. We're leveling our pool in the backyard. I know I'm a little bit late, but we're just about done leveling, and I said, you know, I might as well just make a video. So as you can see, my wife is here. We're about to call it quits for today. Let me walk over there. But what it is we have a hill in our backyard. It comes down, and we put these up here with railroad ties about 25 years ago. All this used to be dirt. So anyhow, the ground was unlevel because you had to have the water slope down, you know, to drain so it wouldn't settle here. But now we're going to put a pool that we purchased from Costco. It's a 22 by 12 foot. So 22 feet long. And right here on these pavers, this is like around 23 feet. Right here, this is... But this is where the 22 feet ends right here. So we figured we put the legs here. We're going to get everything level. But what we did was first we put a layer of sand. We take our level and we go. So we start from here in the concrete. This part of the concrete is level. So from here, that way is where it slopes down. So this part over here has to be raised. These are shingles. If it only needs to be raised just a couple of inches or quarter of an inch, half inch. See, as you can see with this one, what we did was put sand underneath. We put sand underneath, put the paver on top. So we went from this paver to this shingle, which is already leveled. So we just leveled across until pretty much it was level. Once we got it level, I'll just call it front to back and then side to side, because the yard sloped this way and it sloped that way, downhill this way and then this way. So what was that? Away from the house. But if you can see here, those pavers are level. And what we did, we even though the bot on the, I have to get more sand to fill in the gaps, and then we're just about done. But what we did was measure 14 feet by 24. 14 by 24. The box says 22 by 12, so we just went a foot over on each side, except for here. We pretty much got tired. We just went 23 feet instead of 24. Even though we measured for 24, but I don't know if you can see the line. Yeah, my wife said I'm done. We have a line here for 24, but it takes up most of our backyard. So let's see. This video is about leveling. Okay, so here we have a situation. I put my level up already. So here we have a situation where this is lower than the concrete. This is lower than this one, and this one is level. This one is lower. Let me see if I can show you. Let me back it up. You can see a little bit. It's almost the same height. But right there is not. You know, it's hard to tell on the video, but it's not level. So this one is gonna have to be raised, like so. It's gonna have to be raised. We're gonna buy more sand, put sand under it. We're gonna raise it, and then we're gonna level the 1, 2, and 3. And we're gonna do that all the way across. Now that's 14 feet. Even though directions say 12, but that's 14 feet. And we do have extra pavers. That's why we have one in the gap here and the gap here. As far as the row is concerned, that row is level from this spot to that spot over there. It's level, completely level. The row is level. So we just need to fill in the gaps here. So whatever pavers we have left, we're gonna just throw them between each row. First, we're gonna put a layer of sand, throw the pavers between each row. We also have roofing shingles. Like here's a big space here. We're just gonna throw some roofing shingles down there, cover it with sand. Any spot that's low enough, we don't want anything, like we already have this one set. This one and that one, they're already level. So anything we can put between that's lower than say this one and that one, we're just gonna drop it in there and then cover it with sand and pack it in there. We also, for the liner, we do have the pool liner that came with the pool. And we also spent money on pond, P-O-N-D, pond liners. They were nice and thick. I think they were like $60 a piece, and we bought two. We bought two from either Home Depot or Lowe's. I can't remember which one. But we spent $120 just on the liners. These pavers cost us These pavers cost $1.48 each. Surprisingly, Lowe's and Home Depot have them for the same price. These are 12 by 12 generic pavers. $1.48 each. Roofing shingles, I bought the cheapest that they had. And I picked those up from Home Depot. And actually, they were the same price at both places. $30.33, I believe, at both places. So I bought two packs of roofing shingles. So that was let's call it $62 for those. The pavers, $1.48. And we had four, so we bought like 28 pavers. So, you know, I'm too tired to do the math on that. But 28 pavers times $1.50. What's that, 56 minus half of that? I don't know. You can figure that out. And then what else we get? Oh, sand. Oh my God. All this sand here. So far, we purchased 30 bags of sand. I had to make two trips. It's so heavy. It's 50 pounds a bag. So I already bought 30 bags of sand. We already had we had 8 bags of sand from last year. It was raining so bad, we just had extra sand. We made sandbags just in case there's floods and things. So we used those. And then tomorrow, I'm going to go out and buy another 15 bags of sand. Just in case. I don't know. We definitely need more sand to fill in the gaps. Sand, say, is $3.08 a bag at Lowe's. So let's round it off to $3.50. And times 40. $3.50 times 45. $3.50 times 40 is what? I don't even want to do the math on that. Oh, yeah, yay. 45 bags at $3. That's $150 right there, so. So you see, we're spending quite a bit of money on just getting this pool together. And the pool itself was over $800. I think right now, these pools on Amazon, the same pool on Amazon is going for over $1,700. But anyhow, I'll make this video is almost 9 minutes. Hopefully I can edit it down, but just in case I can't, the next one I'm definitely gonna make shorter. But just wanted to get it started, catch you up. Yeah, we're going to have to fill in the gaps on this. I just wanted to bring you up to date on what we're doing with this pool in this backyard. And then I guess I'll record the next stage. All right, until next time, thanks for watching. Okay, guys, back again for another day of recording. So, we purchased 15 more bags of sand. And in total, we put in like over 50 bags of sand at $3.08 each plus tax. But if you want to level your pool, this is what you have to do. So like so, you have to put sand on the bottom like this. Sand on the bottom. Grab a paver. And I have my level over there, one of them. And then you have to level this one with that one, and then this one with one that's over here or one that's over there cross diagonal, whatever. Once it's level, then you fill the interior with sand all the way up to the edge where it's level. Like, so it'll look like this. Nice and smooth. And then once you do that to your whole yard, then your pool, then it should be all level. Needless to say, I thought we were gonna have enough sand. We probably do, because like I said before, the pool on the box, it says 22 foot by 12 foot, or 22 feet by 12 feet. But we don't know if that includes the legs. So we measured to 24 by 14. So our whole setup is 24 by 14. So that gives us an extra foot on each side, or 2 feet on one side, or whatever we need. It gives us plenty of space. But here is a dip in the dirt, in the sand. So we're definitely gonna need some more sand here. This is not quite level. So back to Lowe's for more sand. It's 110 degrees out here today. So after we dump that bag right there, I think we're gonna call it quits. I may run up to Lowe's right now. It's already in afternoon. So I may run up to Lowe's, grab about 10, 15 more bags. 15 bags cost me like $50. $50 and some change. So yeah, it'd be over $200 just in sand. So just be aware, if you're thinking about buying a pool, you have a yard that's slanted and you need to level the yard, just be aware that you may be spending money on sand or dirt or whatever. But this is what you have to do if you have a concrete yard. Also, we were doing another project, and I might show some footage of the yard before we put the first bag of sand down. And I believe I have some footage of that. I was filming something else, and I might just pop that in the video somewhere. Anyhow, this is it for today. Hopefully, it'll be a little cooler tomorrow, and we'll put the sand down, level it out, and then hopefully put the pool liner down tomorrow and maybe set the pool up. So that's the goal for tomorrow, is to get it closer to the final stage. Well, this is level. Let's see that. See, that's from concrete cross over the sand to the paver. And then this paver, that paver is level. That's what you have to do. Okay, until tomorrow. Let's fade to black right now, and I'll see you tomorrow. All right, I'm back. As you may have guessed by now, whenever I fade to black, it's a new clip coming up. All right, so I went ahead and it may not look like it, but it is 15 bags of sand. I have this hill in the backyard. It's a mountain of a hill. So anyhow, that's 15 more bags of sand. And it'll take me a couple of hours there. So I don't think I'm gonna be doing any more work today. So we'll see what's going on tomorrow. Hopefully it's a little cooler. Today reached 110 degrees. And we'll see about tomorrow. Back, and then you'll see the next clip. Thanks for watching. All right. Okay, what do you know? Gonna put some bags over. Yep.
Just drop it anywhere, we'll figure it out. I don't know why you jogging.
Funny, I was jogging at first.